Hey, what's good, Game of Thrones fans? This is the Confire Crew, and today we're going to be talking about Dawn. Now, we spent a lot of time talking about Dawn, but today we're going to get into the crazy speculation part, the fun part, the off-the-rails part. Now, we've talked a lot about Dawn's past. Now let's talk about its future. The prophecy of Azor Ahai, or some referred to as the Prince That Was Promised, states that when the star bleeds and the cold wind blows, a warrior will draw from the fire a burning sword. Now, we know this sword to be the fabled Lightbringer and that this will fulfill the Azor Ahai reborn prophecy. Dawn has already fulfilled this prophecy in one way. Could this be Jon's proverbial Lightbringer?
The discussion of Lightbringer is one that gets Game of Thrones fans really riled up. Many of them believe that the idea of a flaming sword is just referring to Valyrian steel. If that's the case, what really makes Ironclaw that special other than the fact that it is Valyrian steel sword? That's saying that Jon is the hero that we all believe that he is. We also know that there's other Valyrian steel swords out there. We saw last season, we saw Sam, you know, he took his father's sword. He knew how important it was and the necessity for having that sword. But with this understanding, that means the hero, whoever that person will be, just needs to have a Valyrian sword. And I mean, this seems kind of disappointing that Lightbringer cannot be something more than just a Valyrian sword. So what other sword stands out in the world of Game of Thrones? I don't know, maybe the prophecy-fulfilling sword that was born out of the heart of a star? I mean, Dawn is the most famous sword in the world of Game of Thrones outside of Lightbringer. Now, I know their histories don't really fit. I mean, you figure Azor Ahai's sword Lightbringer was tempered in his wife's heart, whereas Dawn was forged out of the heart of a star. Doesn't really add up. They don't seem like the same thing. But who says that Lightbringer has to be reforged or retempered? Often, I thought that this was more of a proverbial thing, meaning that Jon was going to have to suffer or make some type of great sacrifice in order to unlock the power of Lightbringer.
Now, the show hasn't even mentioned where Dawn is, and ain't no one even looked for it. Heck, last time we saw it, Ned Stark had it and put it at the foot of a bed. Where the sword at? What'd he do with it? Did he put it underneath the bed? Did he leave it in the tower? Did he go bury it in the woods somewhere? Did he keep it? What's up? Where's this sword at? I want to know. What did Ned do with the sword? Now, in the books, it's saying that Ned rode down to Starfall and then gave Dawn to Sir Arthur's sister, Ashara Dane. Now, if Dawn is indeed in Starfall, as a place where the show hasn't even been yet, what are the chances that we're actually going to see this sword again? Well, for that, let's go ahead and take a look at the map, the good old world of Westeros. And when you do, you will notice that there is a location near Starfall that's got a very important character doing some very important research. And that is Old Town and our lovable Fat Sam. Now, last season, Sam spent most of the time just traveling around with a baby and a baby mama that's not even his, taking her places she ain't got no need to be. Okay? We know he's at the Citadel for something, okay? There is a reason that he's there, and I personally think it's for something big, okay? I think it's for something that the show hasn't even really alluded to yet, okay? If you're just a show watcher, not a book reader, I think the show watchers, like, they're going to reveal something. They're going to be like, oh my goodness, I didn't even know that was a thing. Okay, they better, okay? Because the old boring buildup they had to him get there to get into this place with all this book so we can watch him have a nerdgasm. It got to be for something. We already know how to kill White Walkers. We already know how to kill White Walkers, so it's not going to be more of that. It's going to be something big, and I think this could be it. Is he going to find this sword? Okay, we know he spent enough time before the Citadel to steal another sword. Is there another sword in his future? I would like to know what you guys think. What are the chances that we even see Dawn again in the show? And I'm not talking about a flashback scene. I'm talking about current time. In the future, are we going to see it again? And if so, what role is it going to play? Again, we already know that Longclaw and Valyrian steel can kill White Walkers. So what would really be the function or purpose of having Dawn? Just to have an extra sword? Maybe the Night's King can't be killed by Valyrian steel. I don't know. That's a thought. Maybe Jon gets up there and fights the Night Kings one time and he shatters that sword. And we're like, freaking, what we gonna do now? We just go cut my sword up like that, foe. That's not fair. I don't know. Maybe. I mean, maybe Dawn is Lightbringer. Maybe that does fulfill the prophecy if you believe that actually sword is burning or whatever the case may be. This is just fun, man. We just have a speculation like we always do, throwing some information out there, some little nuggets or whatnot. What do you think? That is the video for today. You know how we do, man. If you like the video, share it out. And if you like our content, you want to see some more of our dumb, retarded content, hit that subscribe button. Until next time, guys, we out.